Good morning to all. In previous class, we discussed about the specific acceptances, quantity of heat absorbed by release, specific acceptance depending on the nature of acceptance, among all the matter, water has highest specific heat. Because of higher specific heat of water, it regulates the, it balances the temperature of the surface of the earth. To find the specific heat of some substances, we use an instrument is called as calorimeter with the help of the principle of thermometers. Net heat lost by hot bodies equal to net heat gained by cold bodies. It is a principle of thermometers. We derive a formula to find the temperature of a mixture. Take two beakers. One is filled with 100 ml of water. Its value is 100 ml or 100 grams. Problem. Number one, it contains 200 ml of water. All grams. This water at 60 degrees centigrade, this water at 90 degrees centigrade. Both are different in their masses, different in their temperatures. Mix them in another beaker, big one. 100 ml of water at 90, 200 ml of water at 60. Both are mixed in this. Now, how can you find the temperature of this mixture? That is resultant temperature of the mixture. Now, from the principle of thermometers, heat lost by the hot body is equal to heat gained by the cold bodies. Here, hot body is 100 ml of water at 90, cold body is 200 ml of water at 60. The resultant temperature, let it be 3 degrees centigrade. Now, mass of the first one is m1 equal to 100 grams. Mass of second one, m2 equal to 200 grams. Temperature of the first one is t1 equal to 90 degrees centigrade. Second one is t2 equal to 60 degrees centigrade. Now, it is the both of them. Now, resultant temperature of the mixture. To find it, we derive a formula by using the principle of method of mixtures. Heat lost by hot body equal to heat gained by cold body. Heat lost by hot body equal to heat gained by cold body. What is the formula for heat? Q equal to ms delta T. It is the formula for heat. Q equal to ms delta T. M is mass acceptance, s is specific acceptance, delta T is change in temperature. Now heat lost by the first one, mass m1, specific heat is s, change in temperature is at high temperature, resultant temperature is T. T is less than 90 and more than 60. So, change in temperature is 90 degrees minus T. Temperature of the first one changes from 90 to T because it loses the heat equal to heat gained by the cold. Here, cold body is M2, its temperature is T2. By mixing it with hot water, the temperature rises. So in this case, the resultant temperature is more than the temperature of the cold body. Now, M is delta T. M is mass acceptance. S is specific heat of water. Change in temperature. In resultant 60, resultant is more than the 60. 60 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड. बोथ एस इट इज स्पेशल हीट इन बोथ द गैसेस फ्लोज द वाटर. नाउ स्पेसिफिक व्हाट इज 1. नाउ m1 इट इज टेकन एज t1. इट इज टेकन एज t m1 t1 माइनस m1 t इक्वल टू m2 t माइनस m2 t2. सो फर्स्ट वन टेंपरेचर इज t1, सेकंड टेंपरेचर इज t2, रिजल्टेंट वन इज t. बाय मल्टीप्लाइंग दिस वन m1 t1 माइनस m1 t इक्वल टू m2 t माइनस m2 t2. नाउ m1 t1 प्लस m2 t2 इक्वल टू m1 t प्लस m2 t. Here t is resultant temperature. From this m1 t1 plus m2 t2 equal to t into m1 plus m2. Now we want to determine the resultant temperature t. That t equal to m1 t1 plus m2 t2 by m1 plus m2. The formula to find the temperature of a mixture. T is resultant temperature. M1, M2 are masses of the bodies. T1, T2 are their temperatures. By using this formula, to determine the temperature of a mixture. Next one, by using this one, principle of mechanical mixtures, we determine the specific osmosis. For example, specific of copper is 0.095. By using this one, we determine the specific of lead. It is unknown quantity. To determine this one, we use calorimeter. The instrument to determine the specific osmosis. This calorimeter is made with copper. It is cylindrical vessel made with copper. Its specific heat is 0.095 calorie per gram. Now this copper calorimeter is fixed in a wooden chamber. The gap between this vessel and this one is filled with coil or the mouth. It has a lid also. It has two holes. One is to insert the thermometer and the one is to fix the stirrer. Stirrer is a device used to stir the contents. Stirrer, it is a rough diagram of calorimeter. We want to find the specific of lead shots by using the specific of copper vessel. First, find the weight of the calorimeter with the help of spring balance. Let it be m per grams. It is mass of calorimeter. Is m1 grams. Now pour some water into it after hour. Now again find the mass of calorimeter and water. Mass of calorimeter and water. Let it be m2 grams. Mass of calorimeter and what is m2 grams. Now mass of water only is, mass of water is m2 minus m1 grams. It is the mass of water. Now measure the temperature of this calorimeter and water. Both the same temperature. इनिशियल टेम्परेचर, इनिशियल टेम्परेचर इज 31 डिग्री सेल्सियस, बोथ एट द सेम टेम्परेचर. नाउ इन अंदर बीकर टेक सम लेड शॉट्स अंदर बीकर. दिस आर लेड शॉट्स, हिट द until it boils. Its temperature of this lead shot is 32 degree centigrade. Temperature of lead shots. Lead shots is 32 degree centigrade. Now quickly transfer the lead shots into the calorimeter. Stir it well for some time and measure the temperature. Temperature of mixture. Mixture means water, lead shots and calorimeter, that is 33 degrees centigrade. Here heat lost by the lead shots is equal to the heat gained by the water and calorimeter. Here T3 is more than T1, less than T2. Now after cooling, find the mass of the calorimetric contents, that means water and calories. Now mass of calorimeter, water and lead shots is m3 grams. So these three masses m3 grams. From this we find the mass of lead shots is m3 minus m2 grams. m3 minus m2 grams. Now know this all areas and apply principle of method of mixtures. What are the principle of mixtures? Heat lost by lead shots equal to heat gained by calorimeter and water. Heat loss by lead shots equal to heat gain by calorimeter and water. Substitute all the elements. What is the formula of the heat? Ms delta. So lead shots mass is m3 minus m2. In the formula Q equal to ms delta. M is mass of lead shots, S is specific of lead shots, SL and change in temperature. Temperature of lead shots changes from T2 to T3. So T2 is greater than T3, T2 minus T3. It is heat loss by lead shots equal to heat gained by the calorimeter. Mass of calorimeter is m1, calorimeter specifically is sc. Change in temperature, temperature of calorimeter changes from t1 to t3, so t1 minus t3. Next, heat gained by the water. Mass of water is m2 minus m1, specific of water is sw. Change in temperature is T1 minus T3. So heat loss by lead shots equal to heat gained by the water and calorimeter. Now we know M3, M2, T2, T3, M1, etc. Now determine point is SL. SL means specific of lead shots, that is equal to m1 sc a1 minus a3 plus m2 minus m1 into sw into t1 minus t3 whole by m3 minus m2 into t2 minus t3. By substituting all the values here, m1, sc, t1, t2, t3, we get the specific of solids. By using the device called as calorimeter, sl equal to m1 sc plus m2 minus m1, both t1 minus t3. T3 minus T1 by M3 minus M2 into T2 minus. Please important one definitions because of this. Learn well. If you have any doubts, call me. Okay, thank you.